Alright, welcome everybody to Mock Rock 2023. Are you guys ready to have a good time?
Yeah!
Well, I like to hear, that's what I like to hear. I'm going to be your MC for the night. When I hear MC, I think about rapping. So I was thinking about rapping, but they told me I couldn't do that. So don't worry, that's not going to be coming. I'm just going to be MCing the night, getting us in between performances. My name is Jordan Reynolds. I work at OSF, so if y'all see me around, say what's up. We'd love to meet you guys. And I know why you guys are here. You're not here for me. You're here for the most wonderful time of the year. And that is not Christmas. That is Mock Rock, the best day of the year. I want to start us off with a little question to let you get to know about your history of Mock Rock, where it's been. If anybody can answer this one correctly, I got a Starbucks gift card for you. Only $5 on it. You're going to have to get something small. But it's a little something. And it's mine, so you better appreciate it. I don't have to give this out. Does anyone know when the first Mock Rock began at FPU?
2020!
No.
3 years ago!
Nope. Getting colder?
2021!
2017!
Nope.
2017!
2018!
I don't remember yet.
2018! 2001! 2002!
This is like highly improbable.
2005!
There it is! Hey, Rias! My man, congrats. He probably cheated, I'm not gonna lie, but he gets to enjoy some Starbucks anyway. Awesome.
All right.
I'm so glad you guys are here tonight. What you guys can expect from the performances tonight is basically, this is the best of the best. This is essentially the Olympics of performances here tonight. These performers, they have been working tirelessly towards the performances they're gonna put on. You know, I've heard some of them, they said, you know, before they could even talk, they were practicing their lip syncing. From the moment they could walk, they started practicing their moves. They've been putting on for a lot of years to put these performances together, and so we're gonna see some magical, beautiful things tonight. But one thing we're not gonna see tonight is no jeers, no sneers, only cheers. Keep that in mind. If y'all brought tomatoes with you tonight, you better either eat those tomatoes or throw them away. They won't be thrown up here. Keep them to yourself. The only people who will be critical tonight are our judges. So let us introduce our panel of four judges. First up.
I will go first. Hey everybody, I'm Taylor. And if I was doing Mock Rock, so I've never done this before, so I'm just going to go with my karaoke song. It would be Whitney Houston, I Want to Dance With Someone. Yeah!
Hi. I'm Dr. Pam. And if I had to be up there on the stage, I'd be doing Bohemian Rhapsody.
Hello, I am Kendall. If I was on the stage, I would for sure be doing Hey Now from the Lizzie McGuire movie.
Hi, I am Tim. I have a 6-year-old daughter, so this one's easy. It's me. Hi, I'm the problem, it's me. I would definitely be doing some Taylor Swift.
Well, thank you, judges. It's really a shame we can't have you guys up here. All of those sound like great choices, but I guess we'll just have to settle for what we have coming up. And up first, we have the activities team. They were such heavy favorites to take home the prize that we couldn't let them compete for the normal prize. It would just been too easy. So they're gonna come up, give us a little example of what you're gonna see tonight in Mock Rock, and then we're gonna get into the performances that are gonna count by the judges. So first up for the activities team, we have a band who has four more cardinal directions than the original, and they're five times better than the original, and that is Five Directions. Give it up. Members, who would you be?
I don't know. Harry Styles?
And Ariana, which one of the original One Direction members would you date? Safe answer. All right, we'll let her slide. We'll let her slide. Thank you guys very much. We won't hear from the judges for them because, again, they will not be getting scored in the regular competition. But we will be hearing from the judges after the rest of the performances. So, one more round of applause for Five Directions. All right, if you thought that was good, up next, we have a Disney original coming all the way from East High in Utah. It's Troy and Gabriella as the Polo Boys.
Doesn't seem like these days. Life keeps getting in the way.
From Wildcats to water polo, these guys can do it all. So guys, heck of a performance. I got some questions for you. So Blake, you know, a lot of us, we come in, we expect to see great dance moves. We see that kind of performance often. But you showed us a different kind of performance. It was with the basketball over there. Those handles, man. I gotta ask, was there an NBA guy you were studying, you know, and watching?
Yeah, I mean, I strive for greatness. When I hit that game-winning assist to West High Knights, you know, Rocket Man, he put it up for us, you know, help us win. But, you know, I really look out to my man, Rise, right here. You know, number 12 on the FPU basketball team. I mean, no NBA player can match him. So, yeah.
Hey, fair enough. I gotta watch his team. And, Forrest, I got a question for you, man. This is kind of a personal question, because personally, I want to know. Bro, what are you eating? How do you look so good in that dress? I mean, what's your secret?
Troy's parents cooked for me, but I don't know. It's just some whey protein mixed with more whey protein.
protein, and more protein. You heard it here first, folks. You want to look good in that dress, ladies and men alike. You know what to do. One more time for the Polo Boys. Oh. Polo Boys, come back. Before we have them on the stage, we obviously need to hear from our judges.
Pam, do you want to start us off?
I have to admit that from now on, whenever I hear this song, I will see Forrest in that dress. And I will try to put it out my mind.
You know, guys, great work. I would have loved for you guys to emote towards the audience. I think we got a great side profile. I would love to see more of your face.
I thought you guys were great. I thought it was fantastic. Live up to the one thing that the middle part where there was some distance, I thought you could have played a little bit more because the walk over and then the pullback was really solid. I like that. The hug was not as authentic as I wanted. You guys kind of lost me. It was more of a bro hug and it wrecked the whole thing for me at the end. But other than that, I love it.
Great job, guys. I felt like I was watching
a
movie. I haven't seen that movie in a long time. So did great.
Guys, I meant to say this at the beginning, but there is a criteria our judges are grading off of. So if you guys find the winner and you don't agree, well, this is the criteria they're looking for. And that would be, 1, lip synchronization. 2, is their appearance, which, as we can see, they did pretty well with that one. Crowd engagement, choreography, and overall entertainment value. I think they really brought it, but those will be the things our judges are looking for from our next performers. Up next, we have a mock rock professional, and that is Paulina Zhu.
That's my car.
Sometimes my dreams come true, oh, sometimes they turn to blue.
keep on clapping one more time for Paulina Zoo. Awesome stuff. So Paulina, my question to you, we have, obviously, there's a lot of stakes here going on. You know, you're competing for a $400 prize. And my question to you is, if you won the $400 prize, what would you do with it, and would you or would you not solve world hunger?
I think I'd help, like, solve world hunger in my family. So I'd save it so later on, like, we can buy a house. So I'd save it, honestly. Yeah.
You heard it here first. Selfish for solving hunger. I guess we don't need to. Just kidding, Paulina. Thank you. Stay right here, Paulina. We're going to hear a word from our judges now.
Just bravery, just getting up on stage and just going through the dance and everything. I just thought it was awesome for you to get up there and do that. Not a lot of people can do that, so congratulations. The dance was awesome. I think you probably jeopardized a little bit of the lip singing because your dance was just really, really solid, but I thought you did an awesome job.
More lip syncing, but you killed that choreography. Good job.
Loved the way that you incorporated your scarf as well as your interaction with the crowd as part of your choreography. I think that created an atmosphere where people were involved in your choreography, and so it just like created a whole like moment.
Thank you.
I really feel like I got my exercise in for the night watching you. So great job, great energy.
Thank you, all right, now I know you guys already know this is a special night, but if you didn't know, now you know, because for the first time ever, these ladies have left the pool to join the dynamic duo of H2O. Sorry about that.
Stop. Oh, I can't stop singing.
I don't think you guys need me to say it. Give us another round of applause for that. I think you guys are fine. All right. Thank you, ladies. What a spectacular performance. Now, as great as that was up here, I know you guys don't tend to use your legs for walking much. You're often in a pool. So, in all honesty, if this place was more conducive, how much better would that have been if you were in a pool?
You know, I think that if we took this and did some synchronized swimming, we could really show you a once-in-a-lifetime performance.
But nonetheless, we were all inspired. And speaking of inspiration, Natalie, what inspired this performance? What gets you up in the morning?
Ross Lynch.
You're speaking my language, Natalie. Honestly, he was kind of my role model in my teenage years. He still is. Awesome. Let's hear a word from our judges.
That was some fabulous lip syncing. I couldn't remember times that you were actually lip syncing. It was that good.
Yeah, you did. A lot of like bravery from standing up on the chair, running in those socks. Like, man, that's commitment. So, and thanks for taking us to the beach. That was good.
You know, I felt like I needed a beach vacation before this, and you know, I feel like I just went on one, so thank you.
Just the charisma, the lip singing, the choreographed dancing, I thought it was just phenomenal. You guys crushed it.
Thank you, H2O. And the volleyball skills. All right, so we're going to take a short break from our performances for a little intermission, but this is not a lazy intermission. We need some audience participation for this. We are going to be playing some musical chairs, and we need 10 volunteers from the audience. Come on down. Y'all are brave enough, just come down. I don't have to quit. I'll sweeten the deal. There is a winner for the prize. I'm going to call out Kira Wilmer. Is Kira Wilmer in the building? We need her to come down and play. I was told to call her out. Three more. The faster we get done with intermission, the faster we get back to performances. One more. From the VIP section, Chris! We need one more? Still one more? One short, come on. We need one more. Oh, Chris, yes! In the sandals, too. Perfect footwear for this. Chris with no footwear, actually. Okay. All right, I don't need to explain musical chairs. Y'all know what to do. Let's get to it. Caught up in his dance moves. He was too busy waving his finger. Hey, Chris is safe. What a turn of events. Could he get his hips down in time?
Baby, can't you see?
Except we have a rematch!
Halftime performance in half the time with Redesign! Beyonce or Rihanna?
Definitely beg every read.
Yeah. You heard it. Riri it is. And I have a question for Riri herself, Mary. I want to know, do you wake up feeling like Rihanna every single day? Because it sure looked like it today.
Yes, I do.
Yes, she does. I believe it. Brooke has an announcement.
There was a little bit of Chris cash in the money that we threw out, so try to look for that.
Driving the audience, that might be a penalty. We'll have to talk that one over. All right. Great job, redesign. Let's hear it from our judges.
I think you guys really captured the essence of that Super Bowl performance. Riri has some competition. She has some competition.
I was just amazed and wowed by the amount of choreography that you guys had. And we said it was shortened, but my goodness, you guys had so much jam-packed in there, so great job.
I think some of the choreography may have been a little scattered, but it certainly was creative.
I'm with Pam a little bit. First off, it's always Beyonce over Riri, so... Sorry,
just lost points of 10.
I I think less could have been more. I thought you guys probably worked so hard and got up there and had so many different dances that maybe just a little less would have been better. But I thought it was really good.
I have different opinions. I am also Rihanna,
so I would say, but anyway.
I will say it with my chest, I think Beyonce is overhyped, but Rihanna overhyped.
Ruffling all the feathers, wow. All right, well, thanks for joining us.
There's room for both. There's room for both.
That's good. All right, one more round of applause for Redesign. Keep on looking for your Chris Cash. It's somewhere out there. All right, up next, we have Angela, Sarah, and Soraya, and they're here to bring the Barbie dream world into reality. All the glitter, all the glam, all the glam. I'm sorry, folks. We've just been informed that the Barbs could not make it this evening. But in their place, we have the Bad Boys. Inspiration do you draw from Riff Raff as an individual for your look tonight?
Sorry, my homeboy, he's just a little too emotional right now. But I'd like to make a shout out to Ashadi, Ellie Scully. You're the real one. She really held it down for us today.
We appreciate that. I understand why she's emotional. We all are too. That was breathtaking, honestly. My other question is, guys, when's the album dropping? You guys are the most impressive rap group I've seen in a while. You guys have a debut album coming soon?
September 24th, 5 PTS time.
5 o'clock Pacific time. It's coming out September 24th. Make sure you guys get to the record store. Get your records. They got a hot album coming out. It's going to be awesome. All right. Well, enough from me. Let's hear from the judges. What did you guys think?
I was transported back to middle school, and I'm going to just say that was phenomenal, and that was the trip down memory lane that I needed. Thank you.
I thought it was a ton of fun. You guys brought the energy, and it was a blast right from the get-go. Good job.
So, this is a selfish question. Is there room for one more? Okay, just keep that in mind. Keep that
in
mind.
You're in, Taylor. You're in.
Love the energy, love the choreography. Great job.
That was a great trip down memory lane. We're going to take another trip with this next group, and that is over to Middle Krause. These guys have just two goals tonight. One of those is to win the grand prize, because they need that $400. They need to buy soap this year, and honestly, you guys want them to win and have soap as well, if it's ever for all of us. So that's a main reason they want to win tonight. But the other thing they want you to know is exactly where Middle Krause is. They don't want you asking, where is Middle Krause after this? So let's give it up. Middle Krause.
Yeah, Tyler!
Because I am such a hard-ass I have to fucking pass, take it down on your knees. Cause it's a whole new life, I'm fucking good enough. Did you ever fuck me, would you ever get your ass?
About the Roman Empire. I want to know something about you as a man. What do you think about more, the Roman Empire or Ice Spice?
I love you, Danny!
I think about one thing. I want to thank Strauss One for giving us your flag. I mean, we'll give it back right after, but I definitely think about Ice Spice more than the Roman Empire. I mean, come on, come on.
Fair enough, you might speak for a lot of us, I don't know. All right, judges, it's your time. Tell us what you thought.
On a fun scale of 1 to 10, I had a 12. So that's where we're at.
We found Kendall's taste. Kendall's an Ice Spice fan.
Yeah, pulling out all the stops. I mean, we got Ice Spice over here. Look at you.
While we're waiting, I gotta ask, is this natural? Is this a natural look for you?
Yeah, it's a pretty natural look for me, you know?
That's good. We don't like props, we like the real thing, so we heard that first.
That was Ice Spice. I thought it was Ronald McDonald.
And only the judges can be critical tonight, that's fair. I don't know, that's tough. Tim, what you think, man? Is this your cup of tea?
It was a total vibe. I thought it was awesome. And to be honest, when it started, I thought, oh, this is fun. This is what Mock Rock's about. This is a good job. And then, like, the main attraction came out and just hammered it. It was just... fantastic. It's what the night's all about. You guys did a great job.
We are going to practice most of this group. We have the most practice. All right, thank you guys. We are going to take one more intermission. You guys can leave the stage now. I'm not trying to get you off. All right, that is it for our performances. Unfortunately, that is all we have tonight on the performance side. So we are going to take a short intermission so the judges can tally up their points and we can come to a conclusion on who is the 2023 Mock Rock winner. But before that, we are going to play another game down here. It's called Four Corners, and we need 10 volunteers again for it. Don't be shy. Somebody, anybody. I'll sweeten the deal again. There's a big time prize for the winner. Big time prize. Yeah, Rice is on his feet. He's putting the necklace away. He's getting serious. He's unloading his pockets. He's ready to go. We got three, I think we see a fourth, a fifth coming down. Jan is coming up, the human fish. We've got six, we need four more brave souls. You guys have just watched the brave souls in the school perform in front of you. Take some of that rear view, come on down.
It's easy. Come on, we need more. We need more. We gotta get the show on the road. Julie? Come on.
Alright! We got nine. We have room for one more. One more brave soul. Tato! Come on now. Alright. I'm gonna pass out to Julian real quick. Give us a short explanation. What is this game intent?
So, this is called Four Corners. So, if you guys have ever been to a skating rink, you know that game where you're skating around and then you choose a corner, and then a random corner gets chosen, whichever corner is chosen. If you're in that set corner, you are out. So, don't choose the wrong corner is pretty much the game. Everyone understand? You can skate if you want, yeah. You can imagine it. So, the music will play. You guys will start circling around. Ari will be blindfolded up here, and she will choose a random corner after I spin her around a couple times. Sound good? All right.
Let's play some Four Corners. Woo! is spinning. She doesn't know which direction she's facing. She's in corner, Ari. Oh! Top left. Ryan's unloaded his pockets for nothing. He's out in the first round. A little embarrassing. All right, round two. Ari is going to be so dizzy after this. Alright, we're already in round three. We've got five contenders left. Who will Ari choose? Oh, not Jan! It was a good round, Jan. We're down to just three contenders left and only four quarters. Can they stay safe on this one? We'll see.
Now, if she chooses the corner that you are in, you are the winner of the game. If she chooses your corner, you are the winner of the game. Does that make sense?
All right, the stakes have changed. You want to be chosen now. Where are they going to go? Interesting strategies going on. Michelle, would you stay with us for a quick interview? Michelle, you just won a Super Bowl. I mean, four corners. What are you going to do now?
Go see who the winners are. I
want to
know who the winners are.
She wants to know who the winners are. So do we all. We have a prize for her. We don't know where it is. She doesn't get a prize. It's a satisfaction of winning. And that's all that matters. Another plot twist. She does get a prize as a shepherd. All right. All right. It sounds like we have not come to a decision yet on the winner. That doesn't surprise me. There's some fierce competition, so we're going to play one more game. Again, we need audience participation. We're gonna play Duck Goose, though. The best game there is. Can we get some volunteers? Tatum was supposed to play so bad. We have five participants. Can we get five more? We have one on the way down. We have two on the way down. Three more spots left. There will be a prize for this winner. We don't have your prize right now, but we'll get to you later. Is this a content right here? This is it, all right. These are your performers. All right, it's time to Duck Duck Goose. Honestly, I don't know how Forrest is gonna get up with that dress on. It might take him a little while. All There is only one fair way to settle who goes first, and that is the classic deciding method that the Roman Empire also used, and that is nose goes. Go. Alright, so Duck Duck Goose, apparently we need a refresher on the rules. The music will start. You're gonna go around and you say duck, and you say duck, and you say duck, and you might say duck one more time, but eventually you're gonna say goose. And then you're gonna run, and that person who's the goose is gonna chase you, and you gotta sit down before they tag you. Loud and clear? You got it, guys? Alright, let's play some Duck Duck Goose. You can start sitting, and we'll get up when the music starts. Targeting involved in that, you knew she had socks on? A wise target. I guess we're gonna have you be out. Back out. Let's go to the right. Let's go to the right of you. To the right, you're up now. To the victory. Sorry, Shakira. You have to take that out. All right, to the right. Paulina, you're up. We'll go to the right of the person who sits down. He got it! He got it! Paulina was out. She thought he couldn't get a proving address. He's been proving us wrong with that dress all night. All right. Natalie is up. And she cruises into a safe slide. Good job. Alright, Devin, that means you're up. Okay. Alright, buddy, let's see it. Let's see that track speed. Let's see that track speed. There we go. There we go. Oh! Woo! A risky slide. Wide with her. Not say yes to the dress. Forrest is safe. Devin, you're back up. Let's get it.
Please don't. Hey, Devin.
A technical foul, the next one will be an ejection. Please double dot them. Not at all. Alright. Oh, you got it. That's 2 out of 3. The gentleman's way to play. We got 1-0. And we have a winner! Oh, wait, what is your name, man?
My name is Maximilian Anthony Pachile I.
Maximilian and a million other names. You heard it here, folks. That is our winner. We don't have a prize for him right now, but we will. Congrats, Maximilian. All right. Did you guys have fun tonight? All right, we're gonna bring out all of our performers out to the stage, and this is the moment we've all been waiting for. We're gonna find out who the winner is. All right, can we get one more hand for all of our performers tonight? Take them out. I'm just honored to be on stage with this much talent, honestly. They killed it tonight. But unfortunately, there can only be one winner. And it was super close. The winner only won by 2 points. And the winner is... I really hope I don't see Marvius. The Bad Boy! $400.
So my name is Bad Bunny, and I'm probably gonna take a trip.
Yeah! Bad Bunny's gonna take a trip. We don't know where, but he's taking a trip. Awesome. My next question: what do you guys think won for you? Obviously, we had some great competitors out here. What was it that made you guys stick out and got you over the top?
I want to say Bad Bunny. That really sold us having her on top, and then the flower throw. It sold it for us.
Bad Bunny was the deciding factor. Bad Bunny over Ice Spice, apparently. Well, we thank you guys all for coming out. I hope you guys have had an awesome mock rock. And let's give a warm round of applause for our winners and our performers. We hope you guys will join us next year at Mock Rock 2024. Hope you guys have an awesome night. Once again, tune in. Looking for another way to get up on the bench, but I'm getting on the table and I'm getting on the
Yeah, that's Daniel. Yeah.
This is our moment, tonight is our night. Thank you. fluff.
Hold on, let me turn this off first.